Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with a brand new release by Altenew. Just like with every release, you will find lots of stamps, matching dies, as well as stencils, and they have even came up with new 3D embossing folders. Two of them have lovely flower designs which are great for generic cards, and the third one has a big hello on top of it. Now this video is actually part of a blog hop, so if you want to check out all the products, if you want to see ideas on how you can use them and decide what you really like, then make sure to visit all the stops. I will be making 4 different projects today, 2 cards and 2 tags, and you can see many of these products in action. There is also a giveaway on my blog, so make sure to click the link that you will find down below. For my first card, I'm going to do some die cutting. I will be using the Poinsettia 3D die set. It gives you 4 different leaves that you can stack one on top of the other. I'm going to go with a darker shade of red for the larger ones and with a lighter one for the next 2. If you notice, these dies do cut out the shapes, but at the same time, they do add some embossing, lots of details all over those leaves, which gives a great result. You can cut out all the shapes by using white cardstock and then color them with your favorite mediums. You can even ink them up, and this is going to give you the opportunity to add some shading if you like. I decided to go with just plain colored cardstock, just in 2 different shades. For the center of my poinsettia, I used a gold cardstock. And once I have all the pieces cut out, I'm ready to put my flower together. Now, I like the size of it. You will see that it ends up being a really big focal point. So I am using my bone folder here to add just a little bit of curve on the leaves. And I'm not going to do that for the base, as I want this to lay flat on my card. You can fluff it up and you can even add more layers if you like, if you want to make it even more dimensional. And you can even stick those together with foam tape in between. And this is going to make a really dimensional flower. I'm gonna stick the little piece that I cut out from gold cardstock at the center, but another idea would be to use little gems of gold at the center. I think they would look great as well. So here's my flower ready to go. Now, as a background, I decided to go with this burlap die. This is one of my favorites from a previous release. And for my sentiment, I'm going with a word piece that I die cut with this new die. So now I decided to go with a black cardstock as my background, just because I think it's going to make it look more dramatic and it's going to help that red of the poinsettia and the gold to pop even more. So I'm going to decide on my composition, stick everything down using my glue, and I make sure that all these 3 elements kind of bond together by sticking everything on top of the burlap. To finish off my card, I want to add something extra. For that, I decided to do some splashes with my gold metallic paint here. So I have this watercolor palette by Altenew. And notice that I don't cover up the flower. I want the splashes to be both at the background as well as at my focal point, since I find that it binds everything together nicely. All I have to do is to stick this panel on top of a pre-folded card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And you can see here some close-up photos. And if I have to pick just one favorite from the whole holiday collection, this could be my favorite stamp set. This is called Seasons Tweetings. I absolutely love the birds and how you can put them facing to each other. They can even hold a banner and you can stamp there your sentiment like so. I love that this is a layering stamp set, so you can use different colors to build up your bird. There is also a branch. And there are also matching dies as well as a stencil if you like to use that. This gives you both stencil and mask, positive and negative, so you can use them for different techniques. There are many sentiments to use in this stamp set. However, since I want you to see more products in action, I will be using sentiment for this card from the Warm Blessings stamp set, which has this lovely font. I am going to use my Misty to do the stamping. I'm stamping with crimson. This is the first color, the lighter red that I'm using for my bird. And then I am going to take it out of the Misty and I'm going to use the matching die to cut it out. This is going to be very helpful when I want to stamp the beak as well as the legs. because you can easily stamp them in the wrong position, and when you go ahead to use the matching die, it's not going to match perfectly. So that's why I like to work a little bit backwards here. So back again to my Misty, I'm going to place the negative as well as the actual cutout image, but now I have a reference, so I know exactly where I need to place those layering stamps, and I'm starting with the wing. I'm stamping with velvet. And always remember to prep your new stamps, especially when they are solid, like this feather. I like to rub my palm on top of it, and it always stamps perfectly fine. Now, if you notice, this is not perfectly aligned, but this is okay. I think it's going to be fine at the end. It's not going to show as much. After all, I will have a white border around my birdie, so a little bit of a border in between those two stamps. It's not a big of a deal, and it actually helps that feather stand out even more. Sometimes when I am making a mistake, I like to embrace it somehow and find the good on that. Now I'm going to stamp that little eye, and I did stamp it many times on the side just to see where that white dot is going to end up. And if you take a close-up look, you will see that it's not solid black. It does have a white dot that gives it more life, I would say. So in any case, I did stamp the black area on his head as well as the legs. And remember, my little image is already cut out, so once I have the legs in place, I don't need to do any die cutting. I also used brown ink to stamp the branch, as well as my crimson ink to stamp the berries, and now I'm working on the background. I have a small panel here, white cardstock, and I'm going with my blending brush. I'm going for an ombre look, so I started with the lightest color, which was tumbled glass, and now I'm moving on to peacock feathers, mainly staying at the bottom. This brush is very soft, it covers up quickly a large area, and I'm going back to the lighter color to do some more blending where those two colors meet, and I'm absolutely happy with how that looks. And on the top area, I'm going to stamp my sentiment. For that, I went with black ink, and I'm using this Happy Holidays sentiment from the Warm Blessings. This is a lovely sentiment stamp set that has many, many different sentiments, perfect for the holidays. Now, I am stamping that a couple of times just because I found that my ink pad needs re-inking. And now finally it's time to put everything together. I have some foam tape at the back of this panel, as well as at the back of the birdie, so I'm going to pop him there. I'm holding the branch temporarily, and I'm trying to decide where I want my bird to be placed. And then I'm going to use my Nouveau Deluxe glue and stick down the branch, making sure that it looks as if the bird is standing on top. I'm also going to stick down the trios of the berries. And if you like to add more sparkle on this card, you can, instead of sticking down those berries, you can use red gems or even stickles or Nouveau drops or even tiny little red sequins to add something extra. Now this is where I decided that I want to have some snow on my background. So I'm going to bring in my white spray by Alte Nieuw, and I'm going to do some splashes, making sure that the splashes are not going to randomly go on top of my bird. So I'm just using a scrap there to protect it. Of course you can do this step before you stamp or stick anything on your background. It was just an afterthought for me. So this is going to finish off the card, and here are some close-up photos on the second card for today. Now in this release there are many products that you can use to create lovely tags for your gifts. So this is the holiday tag sentiments, this is the ultimate tag stamp set that you need in your stash. It comes with many, many sayings, including from and to, as well as if you combine it with this die set, then you can make lovely tags, and it gives you many borders that you can mix and match. If you notice in the stamp set, there are stamps like holly berries and such that you can use the dies to cut it out. It also gives you many different borders that you can cut out different panels, cut out these borders at the bottom of your tag to make it more interesting. So many different ways to work with that. So I'm going to show you just an idea. I used the main die to cut out two tags, one out of white cardstock and another time out of the red. and I chose one of those borders. I went with the one with those scalloped edges and those tiny little holes. I find it really cute. I'm going to place it on top of my white tag, run through my die cutting machine, and I ended up having this panel, which I'm going to stick on top of the red one. Now, although the Holiday Tag Sentiments stamp set is designed for the holidays and it has many sentiments that you can use for the holidays, it does come with some of them that are really generic. So, for example, you can use just for you or a gift for you, from and to, in different fonts, which means that you can use this stamp set throughout the year. So for this tag, I stamped the sentiment that says from all of us, and underneath I stamped with black the word to. And here is the finished tag. I just have a very thin strip of gold at the top, just to add some shine, as well as a holly berry that I stamped and colored, and it comes from the same stamp set as all the sentiments. So here are some close-up photos, and let's move on to one more tag for today, using a really adorable new stamp set, which is called Merry Reindeer. The reindeer is holding a banner, and you can stamp inside any of the sentiments that fit perfectly there. I'm going to open up the leaflet so you can see some of the adorable ideas. I think the green one with the berries stamped at the back are just adorable, great design idea. And for today, instead of using him as a focal point on top of a card, I'm going to use him for creating my little gift tag. So I stamped my reindeer with black ink, color him with my alcohol markers, used the matching die to cut him out, and now just to turn him into Rudolph, I'm using stickles, red stickles with glitter inside, on his nose. On one side of the banner I'm going to stamp the tiny little stamp with the berries, and instead of coloring them in with my markers, I'm just going to add three dots with my stickles, so they match nicely with the nose. Now the fun part is that when you use this die, you can see that you get a little hole in between his antlers, which means that you can thread some string there and you have a tag ready to go. Now don't do what I'm doing here. My stickles isn't dry yet. However, I just wanted to finish off the tag for the video and I'm being very careful not to touch it. I did work with heavy cardstock so my markers didn't bleed through the bag, but if you do have some bleeding, just cut out one more piece of white cardstock and stick it at the back. So here are all the projects that I did for today, my two holiday cards and my two gift tags, putting many of the new products into action. Don't forget, this is part of a blog hop. There is a giveaway on my blog and you will find a link to that down below. Just like always, I do have links to everything I used. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.